Hi, welcome to the National Christian Christ Online News. And folks, please, I'd like to introduce to you one of the world's well-known painter from Indonesia, and that is none other than Putu Bunnos Sudiana. And Bunnos, please tell us more about your work. It's called Magic Sound. Why do you call your work Magic Sound?
Okay. Bisa ceritakan bagaimana konsep magic sound ini dan kenapa disebut dengan magic sound?
Magic sound adalah sebuah energi suara di mana kami di Bali setiap hari sedang ada seremonial yang selalu berurusan dengan suara-suara seperti musik, suara genta, terus suara-suara tarian dan sebagainya. Juga saya menganggap magic sound juga sebagai ide saya, magic sound adalah bagaimana suara bisa merubah kehidupan. Jadi sebuah energi suara yang mampu merubah perilaku manusia. Seperti halnya seorang motivator memberikan suaranya, bahkan musik mantra-mantra juga bisa memberikan energi-energi positif kepada setiap audiennya. Dari sana muncul magic sound.
Well, magic sound for him is the sound, the power of sound that came from the any kind of sound related to the spiritual and ceremonial in Bali that inspired him to create and to absorb the power of that sound, to realize it and to implement it into his canvas, into her art paintings. And that sound is at the most time and is his daily life. He is, because he is the Hindu, and in Bali mostly there are so many kind of sounds related to the ceremonial, such as a mantra, a sounds of the priest, a sounds of the gamelan. We call it gamelan. It's the Balinese instrument who that will follow the any kind of ceremonial in Bali, and that kind of sounds always come to his ear and then inspired him to create. And that's why this magic sound concept came from.
So Mr. Bunnos, please tell us, you know, as a priest, you know, you've been inspired with to paint. Behind you, what does the meaning of the paintings that you've done behind you?
Okay. Anda sebagai seorang pelukis dan Anda juga sebagai seorang pemangku, priest, bagaimana hubungan antara jadi pelukis dan bagaimana dibalik sebagai seorang pelukis itu menjadi seorang pemangku?
Ini terpisah. Saya seorang artinya saya seorang pemangku sebagai pemimpin ritual di Bali, itu juga menjadi pijakan untuk berekspresi di karya seni lukis. Artinya, sebagai seorang pemangku dan karya seni ini satu sinergi, sehingga konsep daripada karya lukis ini juga tidak jauh dengan hal-hal yang spiritual.
Well, in regard to be a priest in Bali, it's like a two side of things for him, become a painter and become a priest, for the family priest. But in the end, it has little similar concept. For the art painting he made, it's the foundation, one of the foundations, it came from the spiritual activities he do. And to be a priest, he got inspired strongly to create the painting, the art painting itself.
So, Bunnos, what does your art behind you, the painting, mean?
Okay. Untuk karya seni ini, apa makna di balik karya-karya seni yang dipajangkan saat ini? Konsep di balik hasil lukisannya. Konsep di balik lukisan yang dibikin.
konsep di balik
makna di balik lukisan.
Oh ya. Secara umum my artwork secara umum ini saya membuat color yang happy color. Bertujuan untuk memberikan energi positif kepada audiens. Jadi sehingga getaran-getaran suara itu saya ekspresikan suara-suara yang happy, suara-suara yang apa namanya itu, kidung-kidung yang happy lah, istilahnya, terus kita ekspresikan ke dalam karya seni lukis sehingga berbentuk happy color supaya mentransfer energi positif untuk audiens.
Well, for the painting itself, in general, the meaning is he get a strong power from the sounds, and he created it into the happy color. In the end, the aim, the purpose is to make the people feel also happy to see and the painting itself, and he can spread up the paint. The happiness inside of him and to share to other people into the painting.
Oh, very good. So, Mr. Boudos, what is art to you? What is the philosophy of art?
Apa filosofi seni itu sendiri menurut Anda secara ringkas?
Setiap manusia mempunyai basic arts. Dia mempunyai setiap manusia itu mempunyai karakter seni, karakter arts. Cuman manusia ada yang menyadari, ada yang tidak menyadari. Nah, kita sebagai seorang seniman, setiap gerak itu kita bisa bahasakan sebagai karya seni. Sebagai seni itu kesadaran, sehingga kita bisa menciptakan banyak hal dari basic berkesenian ini.
Well, about the art itself, for Bonus, he said that almost every people and everybody has the art instinct inside the body, inside the feeling of for everyone, but different people has different sense of researching or finding the feeling of the instinct of the art itself, and for him, the feeling and the creation of the art itself is exposed morally and strongly to outside, and that's why he want to say to people that art for him is the dimension to find the real things in the spirit inside.
Now, Mr. Boudos, how important is your artwork now displayed here in Singapore for the first time at Maya Gallery, and why you choose Maya Gallery?
Okay, seberapa penting menurut Anda?
Ya.
Sekarang melakukan eksibisi di Singapura pertama kalinya, dan mengapa memilih Maya Gallery?
Nah, saya kenal sama Maya, terutama Pak Jepri sebagai owner. Saya pernah mempunyai pikiran mau exhibition di Singapura. Saya yakin ketika saya menyampaikan sesuatu kepada semesta ini, saya akan mendapatkan hal tersebut. Dan entah apa alasan dari Pak Jepri sebagai owner memilih karya saya, tetapi yang jelas ini suatu kebanggaan buat saya ada di galeri, di Maya Gallery ini, sebagai first time untuk exhibition yang sangat luar biasa bagi saya. Mudah-mudahan karya saya ini bisa diapresiasi banyak oleh teman-teman seniman maupun pencinta seni di Singapura.
Well, in the beginning, Bonus knew Maya Gallery since long time ago, especially the owner, Mr. Jeffrey. And on that time, he always think on himself and has a mission wanna expose and exhibit his paintings in Singapore in Maya Gallery. And he believe on that time, as always, whatever he thinks a lot, whatever he wanted, and his belief it can be happen some days, and he doesn't know how is the reason and why Mr. Jeffrey suddenly choose him to exhibit his painting here. And for him, for Bonus, this is like a big chance and opportunity to share what he can make and what he can create to wider people in the world. And he hope that people will give the appreciation for what he make and of the, his painting now.
Mr. Bonus, tell us what's next for you. Do you have a plan for the next new set of paintings for your next show next year or in the future?
Bagaimana kira-kira ke depan targetnya? Apakah ada target eksibisi yang lebih jauh lagi atau ada kelanjutan berikutnya? Bagaimana? Ya.
Pasti next 14 Agustus saya ada exhibition in Malaysia. Itu Malaysia Art Fair. Dan tahun ini juga saya mau special drawing exhibition. Saya berproses menjadi seorang seniman ini bertahap sekali, sehingga saya berharap ke depannya saya selalu untuk bisa menampilkan karya-karya yang lebih baik kepada audiens. Dan saya kan selalu melakukan eksplorasi terus untuk bisa berkarya lebih baik, sehingga teman-teman bisa mengapresiasinya lebih baik.
For sure, for the next step and next exhibition, they have already scheduled on 14th of August. That will be exhibited in Malaysia, and also another exhibition in Bali during this year. And for him, I really want to create something step by step. He grew up to paint and to make the paintings since really basics and step by step, and every time he really want to increase what he can make and what he can share to the people to make always the better after the next.
Before you go, Mr. Bonus, what was your influence of art? Who influenced you to become an artist? And what is your favorite color in your work?
Awalnya siapa yang ini menginspirasi? Kenapa bisa jadi pelukis? Ada inspirasi dari orang atau terus apa warna favoritnya?
Saya suka melukiskan dari kecil. Dari kecil waktu masih saya sekolah di Nusa Penida Island, saya suka melukis di seperti biasa anak-anak kecil kita bisa melukis di pasir, kita bisa melukis di bot jukung itu. Terus kemudian saya ada energi bahwa saya yakin bahwa saya bisa melukis. Kemudian saya sekolah seni rupa di Bali, di Denpasar, terus lanjut sampai ke universitas untuk pendidikan arts. Jadi secara garis keturunan kami keluarga tidak ada artis, nothing artis in my family. Tapi karena saya sering sekolah di seni lukis, terus bergaul dengan teman-teman di kampus, di universitas, akhirnya pergaulan membuat berkesenian itu menjadi berkembang.
Terus warna favoritnya?
Warna favorit saya pada dasarnya gelap. hitam, black, coklat, merah, itu putih, hitam gitu. Tapi warna yang paling favorit sebenarnya hitam, black. Saya tidak bisa bekerja tanpa warna hitam. Hitam is energy. Saya tidak bisa bergerak jika tanpa energi. Seperti itu filosofinya.
Basically, to be a painter, it has like not people or another people who influence him to be a painter. It came from his habit when he was a kid, in a children age. He paint wherever there is a media, even on the beach. And normally in our village there is a lot of fishermen boat, and some people there ask him to paint on the boat, and he try to make it. And from that habit, it came the inspiration and the willing, and he believed that he can be a good painter in the next time, in the next day, in the future. And that's why he enrolled continue the school into the art vocational school, and then to art of university in Bali. And in the meanwhile, the habits and the art what he always do is to paint every time, and knows people and talk with people related to the art people, and then that make him influence him to make to be a painter as now. And the favorite color, he like more the dark color, like a brown, black, and sometimes a red, but the most favorite one is black one. And he always cannot make any of his paintings without black color.
Well, Mr. Bezos, thank you for joining us here at National Kids Choice. And folks, please do log on www.mayagallery.com.sg for more information. And please do come down to the gallery from the 25th of April 2014 to see some of his great works. Once again, I'm Robin Steinberg. Thank you for joining me. Thank you.